In today's class, we'll start continuing further our discussion on microcontroller architecture and programming details. So let's begin with the programming philosophy. As we discussed in the last class also, this philosophy would center around registers. Okay, so get my point right. So we have seen, like, you know, there are different levels of programming, and each one has, like, you know, different ways to access different registers in the microcontroller platform. Okay, and these registers are basically, at their fundamental level, they are flip-flops. Okay, so you can see hardware has these different layers. One can understand the hardware in different kind of layers, or and one can understand the software also will have, like, you know, as we'll see now, different levels of programming. Okay, so the base level, okay, is the assembly language, where you can access each of the registers by directly assembly language. Okay, and we'll see how do you do that with some examples of some of the hardware of basic fundamental microprocessor 8085 system, and then, like, you know, we'll move on to, like, you know, more advanced system and see some examples of programming there, and, like, you know, we'll move to further advanced system, which is on ARM kind of technology. We have seen in the last class general philosophical kind of a description or you know, motivation for which ARM technology was developed. Okay, and it has a lot of usages in the modern kind of mechatronic systems. Okay, so that's why, like, you know, it's good to kind of study ARM kind of a technology and its applications or its interfaces that it provides and, like, things like that. So that you are this way you will be able to develop your own mechatronic products in the future, if need be, very easily. And you know, like, you know, what is the state of the art that is happening. So that's why we will work with this TIBA microcontroller, and that TIBA microcontroller will give us a lot of you know, understanding about ARM technology. Okay, let me make it a full screen here. So that, okay, now we will move on to a little bit more details about programming. So if you go to basic fundamental assembly level language, say 8085 system, the programming would have, like, you know, this something called opcode, okay, which is an instruction for like, as in C you have some instructions like that, you'll have some instructions in the assembly level programming, which is, like, given in some kind of a MOV, ADD, like, you know, these are kind of like very short kind of a instructions are there. This MOV, as the name suggests, it moves, like, contents of register A to register C. Okay, so these are A and C, as we saw, are registers in architecture of 8085 system somewhere. So A is a special register called accumulator in that system. So these all descriptions of these all things will be given in the data sheet. Okay, and even these commands and their meaning will be given in the instruction manual for the microcontroller or microprocessor in this case. So this is most fundamental kind of a level programming that one can do, where, like, you know, you actually write assembly language code. Nobody does that these days. Actually, this is just for the sake of, like, academic understanding that, okay, oh, look, finally whenever we assemble our C code, you know, it finally gets into this kind of a program, and this program gets executed in its own way. So finally each of these commands also will have some kind of a hex code associated with that. Okay, so that is how, like, you know, that code will be loaded into the respective registers, and then, like, you know, based on the timing and control circuitry, that one by one, like, you know, lines of the codes will get executed, and that's how, like, you know, your operation happens. So this is both fundamental level kind of understanding of how things happen at the hardware level. Say, for example, when I say moves contents of register A to the register C, there are some kind of a hardware pins to be enabled, and then, like, they need to be made high so that contents of the register A are available on the data bus, and then, like, you know, you enable some other pins so that the contents from the data bus are transferred to register C. So these are kind of, like, you know, micro instructions which will be associated with each of these so-called, like, you know, opcode. Okay, and number of these micro instructions will determine how much time would take, how many clock cycles in particular would be required to execute this command move here. Okay, so that is, like, understanding here. So for any command, so let me switch to this window about instruction set, and in the instruction set you can observe now that there are these many different instructions that will be given. Okay, so for example, like, you know, this is instruction ACI. Okay, so its description is add immediate to accumulator with carry. This accumulator is this register A. So, like, so if you have no understanding of architecture, then these commands will not make much sense. But if you have understanding that, okay, oh, look, this is a accumulator, okay, and this command has this opcode and operand, and then, like, you know, number of time state it takes is 7, or T states cycle, number of cycles of the clock it will take to execute this command is 7 here. Like that, this all these details will be given, and this instruction has hex code, this CE57. So olden days you don't have this, like, a computer or keyboard to kind of program this 8085 system. So what you do is, like, you know, you have this like a LED display in which there are only, like, 8 fields. Okay, so 4 are or 6 are, no, there are only 6 fields. There are 4 of them are address field, and, like, two of them will be data field. So you start at any address and you start kind of coding, like, you know, these hex codes into these different memory locations, and that's how, like, you know, you start writing the program. So which was quite cumbersome to kind of clean. Like, we have done that, like, in our microprocessor course or lab that I was, when I was my M.Tech student here, I did that in one of the labs actually. So it's quite a time consuming process. Also in my B.Tech project I did that actually. So it's very interesting, like, now if I think about, like, you know, how this kind of a, you know, so much of a drudgery to kind of, like, code this and then make sure that they execute properly and say run your motors or you know, any other applications. Okay, so this is a manual. I'll post this also to Moodle, so it will have, like, you know, all the instructions that are available for 8085 system to go. They'll be all there in this. So there are some conditional instructions, unconditional call will be there. There'll be some if else statements, like, you know, how do they execute, like, you know, that you'll get to know, say, for call on positive. So if something is positive, then, like, you'll shift the, you know, address, next address, which will be from where the program execution will restart. Like that, you'll have some kind of a nesting loops possibility, and things like that, okay, by using these basic fundamental level commands. So nowadays all the modern microcontrollers, you just say, like, you know, if else, like, you know, in C language, and, like, you know, your job will be done. But in olden days, like, there is no command if. You'll find in this whole set of instructions for this, there is no command if, or there is no command while. So there are these commands called call on positive, call on carry, or call on zero, you know. So that means, like, when the flag, you have seen the flag register in the last class, when that flag, in the zero flag in that flag register becomes one, then, like, you know, the program, some subroutine will be called from the for the program. That's how this instruction works actually. Okay, call. Okay, so this is how like olden days like this programming used to be done, and that is what is done now also, but it's only like, you know, all the compilers do that drudgery. Okay, so human beings are spared from that. So the like, you know, so we as a programmers for hardware programming write all the codes in C language, and they get executed. Okay, so that's how things happen there. So clear this part. Okay, so far good. So main understanding here is that this 8085 system or any microcontroller system will ultimately have the program in the assembly language that will be downloaded to microcontroller, and each of these instructions, of course, they'll have associated some kind of a hex code with that, and given like, you know, higher level program, okay, that you'll write in C, the assembler, okay, will, or compiler will compile this program and like, you know, generate this opcodes and then like, you know, generate a code which will be only with respect to this opcodes, and that is a code which will be downloaded to the microcontroller memory. That's how the things are going to happen, and you'll see later, okay, when we see the interface of TIBA microcontroller, we'll be able to see that some of these opcodes or some of the assembly level parts of the code which are there in the microcontroller. Okay, so we'll do that. Now let's look at this system again. These are the fundamental operations that will happen in microcontroller at the assembly level. Okay, so or these operations are like, you know, that way the universal, I would say, but one can see there are some kind of a opcodes or instruction sets which are in the assembly level for each of these you know, fundamental operations. Okay, there are some logical operation, there are arithmetic operation, we saw this command add. Okay, then internal data transfer, we saw this command MOV. So like that, there are this you know, branching operation, there are this call command or jump on carry, jump on zero, you know. These are kind of commands which are for branching. Okay, so you are executing some series the commands, and from here now based on some condition I want to execute something else, I'll jump from there to something else, execute that and come back and like, you know, keep doing it. That way you'll have a facility to create loops, and you have a facility to create if else statements and things like that, as I said earlier. Okay, so these are the ways in which things actually happen at the assembly level. So we don't need to get into a whole lot of details here, but we need to have this sense that, okay, oh look, whatever commands I'm writing here in the higher level language, they'll have a compiler will actually compile them and convert them into these opcodes, and then those opcodes will be finally executed for the microcontroller. Now let's move further for a little bit higher level microcontroller. So if you see your Arduino microcontroller or your XCP100, their philosophy is, I mean, philosophy is the same, like, you know, you need to have a finally convert that codes into the assembly level language, but to access the registers, okay, you don't have these register names A, B, C, D as you had in the 8085 kind of a system. Okay, you'll have these registers accessed there in a different way. Okay, so these registers are available as a variables in C. Okay, some variable in C. These variables would be defined in the data sheet of the microcontroller, and also they'll have header files provided to you in which those registers are mapped into those variables are mapped into certain kind of a memory locations or registers finally. Okay, so when you write to that variable, it will go to appropriate register in the microcontroller system. Okay, that data value, whatever you have written in that variable, it will go to that particular register.
And there are two types of such registers. One is control register and other is working register. Control registers for any interface, okay, there will be these two kind of registers. So we'll see some examples. Say for example, maybe we can, okay, maybe we'll, I'll explain first what this function is and then we'll take an example. So control registers set up your interface for particular, or configures your interface for a particular operation to happen, and working register actually supply the working values which will be continuously changing. So control registers you set up only once in your program, okay, and then working register you may keep on changing based on, like, you know, whatever closed loop operation that you are carrying out. For example, if you remember, or some of you might have already done this programming of XCP100, in that this DDRA register was there, the DDRA variable was defined. Okay, so you call is DDRA now register only, although it is a variable in C, like, because this is mapped to a certain register which is fixed in the computer or the microcontroller memory, it can be referred to as, like, you know, DDRA register. Okay, so say this register DDRA in digital input output interface in XCP100, okay, it controls the, as the name suggests, direction definition register. Okay, so DDR is direction definition register. Okay, so it defines the direction for the data transfer in this register, pins of register A. Okay, and this A is a port that is available on the hardware pins of this microcontroller. So this all will be given in the data sheet. Okay, we'll look at this XCP100 data sheet also in a minute. But this DDRA that way happens to be a control register. Then you don't keep on changing, like, you know, the data directions in the, typically in the register. So once you define, okay, I am using this register as an output register, and the pins are connected to some output LEDs, I won't kind of, like, change the direction now. Okay, once it is set, we will execute that for, say, some display of some numbers or dancing LEDs or some LED to glow for to indicate some operation happening. Okay, that is a kind of a functionality that will built into the microcontroller program. Okay, so that way this DDRA register is a control register. Now control register will just, like, you know, set up the things. Okay, it will not put values into any of the, you know, functions actually. So that, for that you need the working registers. So these working registers will actually start putting values in that and outputting something with that you want to execute in your final program. Okay, so for example, DDRA will set this register to kind of have an output kind of a definition for pins of port A, and you actually write to this port A some data, and then, like, you know, that data will be displayed if it is output port. That is how, like, you know, you have written this program. So we'll see that now in a data sheet of this microcontroller. Okay, so let's switch to that. So this is XCP100 reference manual. Now if you see this manual, it will have 1324 pages. Okay, so we don't get into, like, you know, reading all this manual to kind of start putting programming. So we want, like, you know, see this for the module that is responsible for actually doing this data input output. It's this port integration module, and we can directly go to see what is there in that module. Okay, and you can see that you can read through some of these details. There is port A, port B, something are given. Then, like, you know, there are these different variables will be given. Then number of pin definitions will be given, like that. All these things are given. Okay, so you can, if you know this name of some registers, you can look for those registers. Okay, as a, you can say control find and look for these registers. Okay, it's taking time anyway. Yeah, so I say, okay, here DDRA, and I get all the details about this register. Okay, so you can see here. Yeah, so this is data register, DDRA, data direction register, okay, for port A. Okay, so now it gives me all the definitions. Okay, if the value is written there, it will be defined as input port or output port like that. It gives all the description. And according to what is written in the data sheet, if I set up this register some number, then like no, accordingly the functions will start happening in the hardware. Okay, so that's how like one goes about programming these different microcontroller interfaces. So this is like about this simple digital input output interface. Okay, these are like you know many different you have DDR, BDD, RC and things like that. Or then you'll have a port register, port A, port B, port C is a data register. So port A, when you say like the data will be given to this port or like you know, read from this port. Okay. Port C means the data will be, suppose I want to write, or this is port is output port, I'll write this output number into this port, and like depending upon now what is the data, say that data is 10101010, then wherever that 1 is there, that LED will glow. Okay, 0 is there, LED will be shut off or something like that. So you are putting like the hardware pin high and low values on the hardware pin by putting this data into respective registers. That is the operation that takes place in the input output kind of ports. Okay, so this is how we look for like programming for little higher level microcontrollers. Okay, so this kind of a thing you will be able to observe for many different kind of interfaces. Okay, so these different modules. So on this, like you see different chapters in the data sheet, you'll find what are modules that are provided by this microcontroller, or in the data sheet you'll find all these modules that are provided, and more details of those interfaces will be observed in the respective chapters of the data sheet. Okay, so we move on to now the next part. Okay. So typical interfaces will be of these different kinds. Okay, so depending upon microcontroller that you choose, you'll have these different interfaces, and interfaces names also will change from one microcontroller to other microcontroller. Say for example, this digital input output interface, as we saw just now in XCP, it is called port integration module or PIM. In the TIVA, it has a name GPIO, okay, or general purpose input outputs. So like that you'll have different names in different microcontrollers. So don't get bogged up with that. You can just understand, okay, this is your interface that you won't need to program. Okay. Typically for mechatronic applications, from sensors perspective, we'll need these interfaces. General purpose, these are digital input outputs, analog to digital conversion, and then quadrature encoder interfaces. And maybe some serial or other communication modes can be possibility, especially if the sensors give directly the output in terms of serial port output, like a CAN interface, then you'll need these serial or other kind of communication modules to be programmed. Actuator typically will run by PWM module. In some cases, there is a possibility of running the actuator by using this digital to analog conversion also, but in most of our cases it may not happen. Okay, so I think maybe now we will just talk about little bit more details of these interfaces, but we'll come back maybe in the next class. So that you have this small chunk of thing about just maybe base fundamentals of these, and then we can come back to this more details of these interfaces in the next part of the today's class. Okay, so I'll stop here for now.